It was a party, man.
It was love, respect, and fun.
It was.
I got fire in my knees, in my bones, like hot sauce and chicken grease.
You love him and I love him. Put your hands together for Rudy Ray Moore.
I'm Krista Smith, host of The Corner Booth, and here with me today is Mike Epps and Craig Robinson, and we're talking about their film, Dolemite Is My Name. I had never heard of Dolemite or Rudy Ray Moore. This movie is so fun and so touching, and it's just, it has everything in it. Do you remember the first time you saw any of his movies?
Me and Craig, we from the Midwest. That's all they play is exploitation movies and
shit. Oh, really?
I just remember that opening scene. He was having sex with a white lady and the husband came home and he ended up having to run outside naked and like went down a cliff or something. this is something different. I must've been, I don't know, seven.
And did you have the albums at all? Did you know about those?
I didn't really have the albums and stuff. I got turned on to Rudy Ray Moore later on in life, you know. I had already heard Richard Pryor and heard Red Fox mm-hmm. and stuff like that. So I was like, I really didn't get it, you know. And then as I got a little older, I started hearing people saying his slang, his terms and stuff, you know.
Right, like, the godfather of rap.
Yeah.
As he's called. So I know that this had been a passion project of Eddie's for a while and it had a couple false starts, but when it finally came time to make it, what was it like to get that call to be like, hey guys, you want to be in this movie?
I got the call, from my team saying that Craig Brewer, the director, wanted to meet. So I met, kicked with him. He was real cool, but I still had to go audition. So then to get that call saying, you know, that I got the part and was going to be in this movie, Eddie and Mike and, you know, Keegan, it was thrilling.
What was your audition like?
You go in character. I think I got as close to 70s gear as I could get. And then, yeah, I read the sides. It wasn't a lot of
improv. He didn't have to put a wig on either.
I didn't even read for Ben Taylor. I read for another character.
Wow.
But I think Ben Taylor was always the idea.
And what about you, Mike? Were you always with Eddie along the way? Were you part of the process or?
You got guys in the business that are in the lane for certain type of films. I think automatically, especially you get with somebody like Eddie Murphy who knows how to pick the cast himself, because I believe that's what it all boiled down to, was what his vision is and what he wanted to see. And I was glad I was a part of the vision, you know.
And how was it to work with Eddie?
could not have dreamt it.
I'm telling you.
There's a lot of growth there, because you gotta, you know, not fan out.
Yeah.
You gotta, you know, come to play ball.
You must have had a pinch me moment.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And it happened on camera when I go sit and play. Yeah. And then we had the moment of like, you know, this is something big happening. That was one of those moments.
So I know you guys are very funny and you're like, the off the cuff must have just been so much fun, and the lightness of this movie. What was it like? Just take me through a day on set.
So it was a party. Mm-hmm. Eddie had his camp over there. Me and him was right next door to each other. Right next door to each other. Wesley Snipes was down the hall.
Keegan.
The trailer, the makeup and hair trailer girls it was a party, man.
It was love, respect, and fun.
It was.
What the fuck is this? This shit ain't funny. I don't get it.
What the fuck are they talking about? Who was Herbert Hoover?
And it ain't no brothers in it either.
Shh.
Hey, don't speak. Sandy Duncan?
Is there any item of clothing that you wish you could take?
My whole wardrobe.
You loved it?
For real, I loved it.
Ruth Carter killed it, man.
Yeah, she did. Jeez. So did everybody know each other before? Had you guys known each other in and around, just being in Hollywood and being comedians and stuff? Or
for the most part, like different people, like Mike and I know each other. And 20 years. I knew Keegan. Yeah, 20 years.
we met in Canada just for last.
That was
in
98. And you know what you said?
What?
You said, we next.
I did.
Yep.
So I was just saying some shit. That shit really happened.
Did you know Rudy Ray Moore before this came your way?
I met him before.
You met him?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
I met Rudy Ray Moore.
I never met him.
He had a thing on his head. I said, Rudy Ray Moore. Hey. I said, damn. You have to be really culturally in tune to know of a guy like that, you know?
Yeah, so I knew who he was. I had never met him, though.
The comedy of Rudy is the storytelling and the un-PC of it, the vulgarity of it. It's just like all of it is so shocking. And you're half laughing at the shock of it, and then you're laughing at the story of it at the same time, which is just kind of this perfect recipe.
It is.
How do you find that in your own comedy today when you're doing it?
I mean, we in 2019, you got to worry about a little something you say, because times are just different. It depends on what you say and how you say it, you know?
What do you hope people take away from this film, other than learning about Rudy Ray Moore?
A lot of education and history on something that they didn't even know exists. They're gonna understand how a lot of us were made, you know, a lot of black comics.
Mm-hmm. You can beat the odds, but you gotta have a serious belief in yourself. Mm-hmm. When nobody else seems to, you can still win. And he had the vision too, you know? He saw a need, he saw him filling that need. He paid attention to his vision, and he believed in it, believed in himself, and persevered.
I got to get up on that light. If I get up in that light with my own movie, I could be everywhere. I could be everywhere all at once.
Well, it's great to see you guys. The movie's so good, and it's just so inspiring and touching, so.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, thanks for coming by the corner booth.